on the last run, we got tired of like using regular mic stands because it took up too much room. So what we did was I built stands on that's built on the rack.
Literally?
Yeah. For mic stands. So this is an overhead stand. It comes up like that. Mm-hmm. Mic stand goes in there with no bass and it comes up and it goes over the drums. Same thing with the other side.
And you built it on
and
the rack.
And I built it on the rack. And then on this side, we got the same thing. This one here is for the overhead. Clamps in here, goes overhead. But we also got custom lights on the kit too. And the lights clamp onto here. Clamp onto here and it shines like right through the kit. So the whole kit glows. So everything is built on the rack. So you won't see no stands on the floor at all.
Oh.
And then like even on here, this is the clamp for the snare stand mic. So the snare mic goes in here with no bass, comes up, and goes over to the snare. Get your game up, baby. Feel real comfortable. You can still reach while you're still playing. Change his mix without even breaking a sweat. Get your game up, baby. I'm Rex Hardy. This is my kit. Get your game up.
HHX 8-inch, or actually it's a 7-inch,
I thought it was an 8-inch, 7-inch Evolution Splash. And I actually go through a lot of these. Well, at least two, maybe for a tour. Like, I'll probably go through this one, only because they're thinner, but they sound so good. Like, you know, they're real quick, and they give me the...
So we end up having to take two extra ones out.
Oh, yeah. So there you go. That's my, you know, those are my backups. So we have three out, and I'll probably take one home.
After the run.
Right. So that's my first splash. This was is a HHX, just a regular 10-inch splash. So I go between these. Anybody who knows me knows I love my splashes. So these are my main two. My homeboys used to joke a lot with me because I used to play with like four or five splashes. Now I'm down to three. Well, yeah, I still got four. But that's neither here nor there. I have them in certain places. If I only had one drum set, then it would be these three, actually. But I have, but we'll get to the other one. So this is a 10-inch. This is the chopper I was telling y'all about. And I usually just use this for accent stuff, you know, if I'm coming off the snare, you know, whatever. Now this is my secret weapon right here, which this video is very rare because I think I've given this combination to maybe four people. But my stack, and Aaron Spears started this stack situation, but Aaron won't give anybody his stack combination, but he's with Zildjian, so it doesn't matter. But I'm with Sabian. My stack situation, I use this everywhere. It's an APX 16-inch Ozone Crash that has holes in it. And the top is an AAX 12-inch Ozone Splash. So that's what gives you this sound. And either it'll ring less or ring longer depending on how much you tighten it. But right now we got it fairly loose. And I got a Calhoun Splash on top of it, which is a 6-inch. And I love this as well. And, you know, that's one of my favorites as well. This ride is a 20-inch Power Rod HHX by Sabian, of course. This became my favorite ride after I did American Idol last year. And because I have a few other rides I like to use, but this one fits actually everything. American Idol, we play all genres of music, but it works with Mary as well. It has a strong bell, and then, you know, just a strong foundation so I can use it for anything, no matter what Mary pulls out. Over here is an HHX 19-inch Extreme, which is kind of thin, but it's a big crash. You know, all you do is using these little crashes. You might want to fall back if you want to start playing in arenas. Like,
14 is not going to carry that.
Yeah, for there's not a storefront church. No disrespect to them. I just don't play in them. So if I'm going to play at them, I'm going to use these. And either the mothers are going to be mad or they're just going to call another drum. Because I can't play with small crashes because it's like playing splashes. I just can't do it. And I learned that from, actually, one of the first dudes was Teddy. He told me, like, stop playing with them little baby crashes. Lil Jon, Nissan, and Brian Fraser Moore. So if you have a problem with it, talk to them. Don't talk to me. That's who I learned it from. But if you're playing in arenas, you know, stadiums, or even big theaters, it doesn't matter. Play with bigger crashes because they carry across as a crash versus an extremely big splash. You know what I mean? So that's this crash. Up here, I have the Obsessed symbol that I'm known for, which is, I think, one of Sabian's most famous symbols. It's the HHX 18-inch Evolution Ozone. When they came out with this, they just changed the game. They blew cymbals out the water, only because it's a mixture of crash and China put together. So it gives you an attack, but it also gives you the shutoff of a China that you need to, you know, accent certain symbols, you know, certain accents with the symbol, once I say. But so this is one of my favorite symbols in the world. Down here, it's a symbol most people don't see. It's a 12-inch vault max stack. M-A-X-S-T-A-X. It's a max stack. And I just use this for a lot of... You see, it's real quick. It's actually a China flipped over on top of a splash, but it comes as this combination. And over here, it's actually a max stack 10-inch top. This is a 12 bottom.
12A.
Right? 12AX splash bottom. This is something Sid came up with. So I didn't know anything about this, but I'm gonna use it because it sounds good. So these are my two, these are my three stacks. Cause I don't use Chinas anymore, really. I mean, nothing against anybody to use them, but they just don't work with what I do anymore. We get into my size setup. It's a HH medium thin crash, 17-inch, which is actually a heavier crash. But for this particular setup, which I'll explain later, it gives me the detail I need. And over here is one of the first splashes I've ever owned. I think this is a newer one, but it's a hand hammer duo splash by Savian 10-inch. And I used to play it over there, but we moved it to over here to try some different things. Right here, my HHX 14-inch Fusion hi-hats, which I use on my little cocktail kit setup over here with the electronics. I'll explain those. And another APX 16-inch Ozone by itself. So that's my cymbal setup. So now you know every cymbal I use to make me sound like myself. So now I'm gonna let you know with my drum setup, with my electronics, triggers. I'll tell you the difference between triggers and electronics because it's not the same thing. Just because you're playing pads doesn't mean you're playing triggers. They aren't the same thing. But we'll start to my left. This is what I see from my left to my right. This is a little contraption that Sid asked for from Gibraltar to hold my mixer. So, like, you know, what I'm hearing in my ears through my mixer is, you know, all the musicians, Mary, background singers. I have the click separate, then I have my electronics separate. So if it's something that I need to feel more than everybody else, I can turn it up to myself. So this is the contraption for that. We just don't have my mixer here, but we'll have it when we get back to rehearsal. Then we have my 14-inch floor tom to my left, which, you know, it depends on what mood I'm in, but I play it randomly here and there. This is one of my electronic pads by Roland V-Drum. It's a PD-108. So I have this. I actually have two. I have one here, and I have one on my cocktail kit. So you have two of these. Usually what's here is my 808 or my, like, effects, kicks, or whatever. Something I can play with my left hand to, you know, make sure we pull everything off. If I'm mimicking Mary's footsteps or something, you'd have to see the show to see what I mean. This is the new SPD SX rolling pad. It has 9 pads. This is a new one. It lights up. A lot of dope features. You know, I play my snaps, claps. I play thunder. These aren't triggers. These are just electronic pads. Excuse me.
I know you keep a video, but I didn't take it to call.
Get out of here then.
Cool.
Thank you. So I do my electronics, you know, so what I do is whatever circle, I call her set circles or, you know, phases of the show, whatever. So from the intro to the end of the first medley I have.
I'm back.
Thank you. Idiot. So I have her first, you know, we may have it broken down like 4 or 5 circles. So that way it won't confuse me memory wise, no matter how long we rehearse. So I have maybe 1, 2, 3, or 4, maybe 5 sets programmed. So it changes every time I hit this. Right here we have my ballad snare, which works on either all my ballads or just a lower snare. Sid hasn't tuned these yet because we're just coming up with the setup, but this snare is always lower than any snare I have in my setup. Then we move next to my main snare, which is a 13. It's usually always a 13 for her show, only because of the type of music she does. For my main, because I play more mid, high pitch type snares for her show, of course. Then if I need to move to something lower, I'll move back to my ballad snare. Now this is it's a trigger. This is by D-Drum. This is an actual trigger. So for all you drummers out there hollering about, man, I'm into using trigger. No, you're not, because this is a trigger. A trigger is something that when you play something else, it triggers another sound. When you play this, it doesn't trigger another sound. It triggers the sound that you're playing. So that's not a trigger. This is triggering. So occasionally I may have a song where I may have a clap attached to this trigger. So every time I hit this, a clap will go off. So no matter what I play on this, a clap will go off. But that's, it depends on what the song is or once we get to the, you know, the back end of rehearsals. My top rack tom setup is pretty, you know, pretty normal. I got the 8, 10, 12. I got rid of the 8 for a while, but with her music, it was kind of hard for me to just play a 10 and a 12 because of the kind of feels I do. So I stuck with the 8, 10, mounted, you know, normal height. I brought the 12 down some just to give me a different feel, you know, to the way I feel out my drums.
All your drums cut to 7.
Yeah, all these are cut to 7, as Sid said. So it's 8x7, 10x7, 12x7, or vice versa. However you want to say it, that's how I say it. But all of these are 7 inches deep. But they all cut through no matter what. That's DW for you. This floor time here, a 16. I used to play with two floor toms, but I was very rarely using my last one. So I stuck with just one over here, just to give me, you know, what I needed, you know, far as the low end. And by it being so deep, you know, it still pulls through. Back to my kick drum in the middle, I forgot about this. It's a 24. It's a 20 by 24?
Yep.
20 by 24, which means it's 20 inches long and 24 inches wide. I actually started playing 24s thanks to Aaron Spears. 24s are like cannons. Like, they 24s sound mic'd even when they aren't mic'd. 24s are very big. But if you got, you know, you got the right tech or whatever, if you tune it right, it'll come out the way it needs to come out. Then we moved over here, and I'm almost done. Over here is my 12-inch snare, which also has a D-drum trigger attached to it. And I already explained to you what those do. This is my other Roland V-drum pad. This is my 20-inch kit, which I use on my side, my cocktail kit, which also has a D-drum trigger to it, which I can add an 808 or another kick or even a clap. Whatever sound I pick, it'll, you know, pick up what I needed to pick up. Then over here I have my older SPDS by Roland, which is the same as this one. This is just a more updated version of this, but I usually trigger, I'll trigger the sounds from these two V-drum pads from this, because most of the time these never change. I just change them from there. So these three stay the same, and you know, I'll change it from my main brain. But that's my setup. You know, shout out to Mary. D'Angelo, this tour is gonna be crazy. Shout out to my homie, Sid, who put all this together. Shout out to my boy Ed on the camera, put all this editing, everything together. So now you see what I see, you see what he sees, and now you see what you wanna see. And we out.